Hello everyone, welcome to Pediatrics by Dr. Anand, and now we are talking the video number 3. The question, the main question the students ask us is how to make a preparation chart, sir, so that I can remember at the end of the exam. Means my exam is 1 week, after 1 week my exam is there, sir. Now tell me, what should I read, what should I not read, what should I focus on, how should I schedule my everything, because my exam is only 7 to 10 days after it is there. And number one, I would recommend you, we have made 4 videos. This is the video number 3 of the motivational videos and most important question which students have asked. The video number 1 was, how can I be efficient for my exams? Number 2 was, how can I retain well for my exams? This is the video number 3 saying, how can I make a preparation chart or some preparation kind of a thing if my exam is just 1 week or just 2 weeks after my exam is there. Now what to study and how to study. And 4th video is how to handle breakups. Could be a parental breakup, could be an emotional breakdown, could be relationship breakup. So if I have my exams coming and recently someone has expired, now how should I handle it? I would recommend to you to watch these 4 videos in this hierarchy. This is the video number 3. So that's it. So number 1, how to make a preparation chart. Very important this is. Sir, my exam is after 1 week, only 7 days left. Now please tell me, should I revise from page number 1 to page number 500, or how should I synchronize my stuff? So most importantly, point number 1, you should have a revision chit. Now what is this revision chit, sir? I'm not able to understand. I recently had a word with a rank 5 AIIMS student. So what he used to do, whatever he used to study, he used to have a notebook. In that notebook, he used to have his own revision notes. Whatever important he felt while studying, he used to open his notebook and only write small highlighters or small word, like a trisomy 13, 18, 21. 13 is Patau, 18 is Edward, and 21 is Down syndrome. Like that, some highlighters he used to small write, and very small he used to make his own revision notes. And by the end of the exam, he used to only revise those revision notes. He used to focus on them much, because he used to think, this one is important, this one is tough to remember, so I will make sure I note down and I revise this much for sure while going just before my exams. This is one thing, one student personally he has told, sir, this thing you please mention, because this has really helped me. That revision notes could be anything, could be a diagram, could be a flowchart, but that thing should be ready in your mind and in your small revision notes, which will be helpful for you at the last moment of the exam. That's what I'm talking. Okay, that is the point number 1. Yeah, point number 2, this is a very important thing, page number. So sir, what is this page number? I'm not able to understand. Now listen carefully. If you have a book which is of 500 pages, while reading the book, you felt that page number 42 is very important because it has a flow chart of the differential diagnosis of microcytic hypochromic anemia. So this is very important, I need to remember. So what do you do? That page number 42 in that book, you basically turn that book again on the first page, the index page. Before that index page, you have this blank page. There you write that page number 42 is very important, I need to remember this page number 42. Are you understanding? And on that page, either you could put a sticker or you can fold the paper. As the day passes, the days passes. So what? Page number 42, then you felt page number 77 is very much important. Oh, page number 98 has inborn errors of metabolism topic. No, page number 119, I remember most common, this neonatal sepsis, acinetobacter followed by Klebsiella, very important. Anand sir told most common congenital heart on page number 123, that most common congenital heart in Turner syndrome is bicuspid aortic wall, and most common cause of death in Turner syndrome is coarctation of aorta. So what I'm trying to say is that when you end up finishing your book, when your exam is just 7 days or just 1 week after your exam is there, so that time you're not supposed to revise from page number 1 to page number 500. These pages should be your main highlighter. That this is what I feel is very much important. This is what has been repeatedly come in exams and I'm keep forgetting it. So this is what I have to remember this. So once you finish your whole book and starting revising and your exam is 1 week after, so you need to, you will have this list, end up having it that this is what is very much important and this is what you should follow. I hope you understood. That's it. And yes, this is again an important thing. I have my exam after 10 days, sir, what to read. Please, please pay very much attention to this high yield content, high yield content. See, there is nothing known as 100% revision. I never cover 100% syllabus. It is never done because there is nothing called 100%. Because so many recent updates, so many new technologies, so many new questions, you can't cover everything. But what you can cover is the high yield content. If you would have noticed that they will keep asking those repeated questions only are keep coming. Milestones has always been a question. In the JIPMER, in the PGI, in the AIMS, everywhere. It was, it is, and it will be. So there are some topics which are repeatedly coming. So what I'm trying to bottom line is, last 1 week if you have exam left, focus on the high yield, one-liners, high yield content. That will really help you. Not revising from the chapter 1 to chapter 29. Revise what is important. That's it. Okay. And very importantly, summarize big table in one. That's very important. I will have a wall of chits and notes and important one-liners. But you have to summarize them. My exam is after 10 days. If you end up reading like this, you will go mad. But if you summarize all in one, like a flow chart of congenital adrenal hyperplasia, type 1, type 2, salt wasting is this, 17-hydroxylase is the most important enzyme I need to know. So if you summarize in your revision chit, in your revision notes, if you summarize this, it becomes easy for you to pass, and that's what you should do in the last 1 week or last 2 weeks before your exams. Okay, that's it. And very importantly, wall post. That's very important. Whenever you get up, I hope that's very common. Every one of us, we do that. We have these walls posted with lot of important one-liners, lot of important questions, lot of enzymes deficiency. Which enzymes are, I keep forgetting, the enzymes are so difficult. Biochemistry is so difficult. Who will remember? So every day, if in your walls, if those enzymes, those chits, those important points are there, last 1 week of exam, this will be really helpful. That you need to know. All these wall sheets will really help you and they will be really good. Be imaginative. See, that is very important. I personally feel every one of us has a different way of studying. Whatever I'm telling you might not be fruitful for you, but might be good for someone else. What you might tell me will not be good for me, but would be good for someone else. So basically, be imaginative. You think what is important. You think how to study. Some people, they study whole night and daytime they sleep. Some people study only daytime and night they want to sleep. So try to be imaginative. Try to think what fits you better. In the last 10 days or last few weeks of your exam, it will be really helpful. That's it. And you all know that there is no shortcut of success. There is no shortcut. I have worked really hard. We all have taken the stairs to go to success. There is no shortcut. So you also follow that and we will really do amazing. So that's all about this video. Thank you so much, and I recommend to watch all the videos. It will really help you. This was the video number 3. Thank you.